Hello everyone and welcome to yet another episode of Travel Insights. Today we have with us Dev Karwat, founder and CEO of India and Emerging Markets of Travel Tag Kavama. Dev is a man with the mindset of a visionary and the business acumen of a veteran. A thought leader and an inspiration to many budding entrepreneurs, he's one of the most familiar names in the Indian travel industry, though not strictly speaking from the travel industry itself. What makes Dev special is that he not only defined his goals clearly at the start of his career, but he also knew how to turn those goals and dreams into a reality. Dev laid the foundation of Travel Tag Kavama when he was only 16 years old. And today, his dream venture is turning the concept of safe travel into a reality for millions of Indian travelers. Travel Tag Kavama, which is now a part of the Zurich Insurance Group, is one of the leading providers of travel protection services in India, with over 7,000 satisfied clients in retail, e-commerce, and corporate travel, and protects over 4 million Indian travelers each year. While his family's roots in the insurance sector since 1952 laid out his ethics and principles for the business, the acquisition by Kavama Group in the year 2012 added impetus to Travel Tag Kavama's technological and operational capabilities. Dev's foresight, coupled with his passion for traveling, has enabled Travel Tag Kavama to design several innovative ancillary products such as travel assistance, concierge services, and family protection back home while you're traveling. So welcome, Dev. It's a pleasure to have you here with us.
Thank you, Amish Bhai. Thank you for the introduction. I think in simple terms, it would be that, you know, we are all have worked very, very hard to be where we are today.
It's you are really an inspirational story, and considering you started at 16. So why don't we get into it straight? Considering you started at 16, tell us about your past and your journey in the industry so far.
So, you know, just quickly, I started off at 16, you know, trying to issue you know, travel insurance policies. In those days, there were only government-owned insurance companies. It would take about, the normal norm was about 2 days to get a travel insurance policy. You know, I, you know, used my, you know, young age, etc., and tried to convince the government companies there. I would spend a lot of time, would do it in the same day. And this was more as a favor to a friend, which actually I did it. And the travel agent who was involved really appreciated that and engaged me more, you know, often to do it. And that became the source of my pocket money for the weekends. And, you know, as we kept moving along, I think the whole idea was, I realized that there were many more travel agents out there who needed the service that I was providing to this travel agent. And that's how the journey began. And it's been almost about over 20 years now that I've been doing this. I've really enjoyed myself. We've had a great journey. We always had one motto, my team and myself, in this, that we wanted to ensure that we have 100% transparency in what we do. We give the best support. And the idea was to give a best experience to a customer who travels overseas. They're all going for a great holiday, and God forbid if something goes wrong there, right? The whole objective is to make sure that you know, they get the best experience, best service before they come back home. And in this whole journey, I think we've like any other, you know, owner driven organization, we've gone through our own bumps, and you know, it's been the journey has been full of learning. I still remember, I would like to quote an experience, or rather an experiment that we did back then, you know, because we wanted to reduce the time from 5 or 6 hours to even 1 hour. I remember, you know, Domino's had just entered India in those days. And I remember ordering for a pizza home, and I realized they had this thing of 30 minutes or free. And I said, wow, you know, that's a great concept. So I actually chatted up with a delivery boy who had come there. And I offered him a job right there. And he came and worked with us from next day onwards. And he got in another 3 or 4 people along with him. So we were actually hiring these Domino's pizza delivery boys to deliver policies to all the travel agents in those days. Because there was no internet. There was, the only way to issue a policy was using, you know, PC, a dot matrix printer. The policy copies in those days were almost about 20 pages. It was almost like a Bible. And we used to take those printouts and get those delivered to the agents. And I think we've come a long way from there. And it's, now it's all about technology. So that's been a short story for us. We started from a single office, went to about 75 offices all over India in a span of about 4 or 5 years' time. So practically we were setting up like one office almost every month. And it's all been possible because of two things. One is because of the great team that we got, and two is from the travel industry. We got great support. People like yourself, people like a lot of other travel agents, they saw our enthusiasm, they saw what we were doing, and I think we built some great friendship and some great partnerships in the last 20 years.
So when you started, it was basically the Indian insurance companies who were offering these services, and then slowly the international and the private players came in. Did that in any way affect your business, or did you find the competition making things more difficult for you?
In my mind, not really, but a lot of our clients came and told us that, look, you know, the game is over for us, and I don't think we can continue running the way that we were, hiring these pizza delivery boys and delivering policies, because when the global giants came in, they came in with a facility where they could, they allowed the travel agents to actually issue policies from their own office using the, you know, internet, the web services. And we didn't have any web services at that time. So everybody came and told us that this is the end of it and we should, go back doing something else. We were determined that I think we were on the right track. Our objective was right. We wanted to continue what we were doing. So I still remember, I think for about 6 or 8 months, we again borrowed a concept which was running in South Africa, where people would, issue like how in those days we had those, tickets which were stocked by travel agents, right? So similarly, we created, kind of a booklets where we would stock with the travel agent, and they could issue policy from their own office instantly. Mm-hmm. And we would collect the copies in the end, and then we would upload it on our system. And that's how the insurance companies would have records. And we did it as a stopgap to buy those 6 months. And in 6 months' time, we created our online software similar to the global giants. Not of that magnitude, but yes, it did solve the purpose, right? For us to go back to a travel agency, here's the system that you can now issue a policy from your office. So yeah, it's been, I think apart from this, the technology was one challenge that we faced when they came in. And second was the brand, right? They came in with a large global brand. When parents would visit their children in the US, they would ask for a particular brand, branded insurance company's policy. So those were some initial challenges that we had. But due to our constant innovation and great support from our insurance company partners, I think we were able to overcome those challenges.
And you said the technology you developed yourself, so there was no support from the insurance company itself. Is it you developed the platform on which the agents could book insurance policies?
Yes, so I did go to our existing insurance company partner, which is 100% government owned. And I think the response, the feeler that I got, that it would take about 3 or 4 years if I waited for them. So the best thing was to do is, pick up the challenge on our own, and we developed the software on our own by which we could, the front end was ours and the back end was the insurance company. So that was the best way for us to kind of move forward.
What over the years, after having tied up with Covermore Group, how has the company, your company, evolved, especially keeping in terms of technological advancement and obviously the ever-changing customer and consumers' needs and requirements?
Just going back to before Covermore came in, so that was 2010 is when we started talking to them. So the reason why we got Covermore in was, I think we were very clear that we had already created or gone to the length and breadth of the country in terms of the networking is concerned. We had about 10,000 odd travel agents that we were working with. We had the basic technology, but by 2010, I think we were on the top two as a travel insurance medical assistance provider in India. But I think there was a clear understanding that if we really wanted to move to the next league and we wanted to really make a difference to what we were doing, the only way to do that was to bring, you know, a big brother, right? To get somebody who is doing something similar, but in a much better way than what we were doing. And we started our search in 2009. And in 2010, we found Covermore sitting quietly somewhere in Australia, doing something very similar to what we were doing. So they were working with travel agents. They were the largest. They had almost about a 65% market share in Australia. And they had some small presence in China, New Zealand. So they were pretty much an Asian owned company. And I think that's the time when we reached out and we spoke and we thought that it was a perfect marriage because they could bring in the expertise that they had built in over about 25, 30 years in product development, in technology, in global partnerships, etc. So, and one of the reasons why they could bring in those things were because clearly their markets were much more mature than what we were in India. So to give you an example, even in those days, in Australia, almost about 80% of people traveling overseas would buy a travel insurance policy compared to India, where it is exactly the reverse, right? So there are only 20% people who buy travel insurance policy. So if they have gone through that learning curve of going from the 20 to 80, using the right products, using the right technology, using the right, training methods, etc. I think that was the perfect match for us. And I, we couldn't get a better partner than Covermore, who were agile because they were not a large general insurance company. They were a focused, dedicated provider of travel insurance. Another most important reason why we thought they were a perfect match is because they had their own assistance company, which means that if something goes wrong overseas, we didn't have to rely on a third party. So as a business was growing from 2000 to 2010, we were also servicing almost like one or two large claims every single night. While we were sleeping, somebody's managing a large claim. And we always had multiple challenges where how do we make sure that the customer is taken care of, and we're always talking to a third party which is not in-house. So with Covermore coming in, I think that was a big paradigm shift for us, right? Where we were not talking to a third party, we were talking to our own company, a doctor who was the CMO, who was responsible for making sure that the customer is, it was not just about getting a cashless, right? So their thought process was completely different. The thought process was on how to ensure that he gets the right treatment and gets back home safely. So I think that was a complete different thought process than what we were used to in India. And we thought that if we can bring that to India, I think it'll be a great change in the way people actually, see travel insurance as a product, as a benefit as.
Now, coming to technology, how important do you feel it is for the travel and tourism industry to adapt to technological advances? And how do you think it could benefit them, especially coming to insurance services and travel protection?
Firstly, I think in general, the way things are moving today, whether it's a travel industry or whether it's any industry, I think technology has become almost mandatory, right? And making sure that you are relying more on the technology rather than, anything else. And I think technology brings in about three or four key benefits in my mind. So one is you have a great customer experience, right? I think I'm sure all of us would have, I did for the first time in my life, right? Where in the lockdown in the last 3 months, whether using a, food ordering app or whether it was shopping online, I'm more of an old school, right? Where I would like to go to a shop and shop, right? But this is the first time I've actually gone online and shopped. And I think the experience that I've got has been fantastic, right? In terms of, it's so easy when you order online, you want to exchange, you want to refund, you have an issue. There is a chatbot which is opened up. There is AI that they use. I think there is the customer experience that you can get using a technology is completely different from actually picking up the phone and talking to people and somebody saying, I'll get back to you, right? So I think one is customer experience, which is great. Second is it'll definitely bring down the cost, right? So if it's going to bring down the cost, ultimately, you are increasing the customer value proposition. So you can put in more, whether in terms of a product offering or in terms of a price or in terms of an experience, right, to the customer. And that's great, right? That's something which is going to differentiate you. And I think the third is error-free experience again, right? So once you get onto a technology, you don't have the thing of saying sorry, right? Because it's all programmed, it's all happening, right? It either happens or it doesn't happen. There is no in between that. So and coming to our travel insurance assistance program, like I just mentioned earlier, that from a technology standpoint, we use follow the sun method globally. So if somebody's in the US, and from a timing perspective, if there is a claim and somebody wants emergency assistance, they would, and if they call on the number, whichever is the country which is awake at that point in time, will answer that call. It can be India, it can be China. We have a call centers in Malaysia, in UK, in Australia, in Canada. So depending on what time of the day, it'll answer the phone and it'll give exactly the same customer experience because it's all on technology, right? So the moment customer says, this is my policy number, or this is what it is, and this is my assistance number, he gets his support. So I think that's a great example for us to say that, how important is technology for any business in today's terms.
So are you offering some technology platform to travel agents who need to issue insurance policies?
Yes. So I think, starting with a very basic platform, which was in 2000 when we started off, now I think we offer a full experience to a travel agent where, if he just, punches in the passport number of the customer, whatever he wants to issue the products, our products for, he'll get a full blown pre-filled details about that customer, because we have records now of almost about over 10 million people on our system, right? Who've bought products from us, etc. So it doesn't matter where he's bought it from earlier, but the moment he puts his passport number, he gets all his information, right? So that saves time for a customer, for a travel agent. Second, he can actually now customize a product online. So let's say if he wants to increase a cancellation cover, if he wants to increase, if he wants to add on a adventure sports cover, depending on which destination his customer is traveling to, he can actually customize that online. He can choose a plan online. And he can do his payments online. So I think it's now like a full-fledged sort of a front-end system for a travel agent where he can, doesn't need to depend on calling us or anything. He can be independently, he can manage the customer.
And do you offer some solution to travel agents where they can put this on to their website so that the customers can directly issue insurance policies? Something like an API or something?
Yeah, sure. So we have, we are already integrated to two largest airlines in India. So if you go on their website, you'll find our products integrated in their booking path. We have integrated with two large OTAs in India, where again, it's on our products are on their booking path, right? And a customer can buy. And similarly, we offer the API services to our travel agents who, if they want to, make us part of their, booking path, we are more than happy to do that.
Yeah, because I mean, the way we look at it is now post-COVID, I think the requirement for travel insurance would like really increase. Everyone will be wanting to have an insurance policy. So maybe a solution where the travel agent can tell a customer on the move whenever you want, you can go ahead and issue the policy may help.
Yes. So I think the prominence of travel insurances is going to increase, I think, leaps and bounds, right? So like there is a, internal thing going around in the insurance sectors where they say that after China, the next probable cause of this COVID could be travel insurance companies, because that's the next beneficiary that they may have. But yes, I think definitely it'll increase a lot. People always bought, even in India before the COVID happened, almost 65% of the travel insurance was bought because of the Schengen visa requirement. But that's going to change now, right? That's going to change. People are now interested in knowing what's covered, what's not covered. They are interested in knowing what are the other options available. They're interested in knowing, the questions that are being asked now is not about saying whether will I get a cashless when I'm abroad or not, or what's covered in the policy, what's not covered in the policy. I think the questions that are being asked is, who's the assistance provider? Which means that who's going to help me if something actually goes wrong? Is it this company? Is it that company? And I think that's the first step of evolving, right? From where we were, I think, a couple of years ago. So we're definitely moving in the right direction.
Maturing as a new
yes.
service.
Yes. And, you know, as we speak today, you know, our conversions, our numbers that we are doing with our OTA and airline partners, which was about, you know, before the COVID and the post-COVID, have gone up almost by about 60-65%. So more people are acknowledging that they need to have a cover at the time of buying a ticket, not later on when they're about to travel, which eventually then they forget, right? And they never end up buying. So now it's... While you're buying a ticket, they want a cover because they're not only worried about the medical conditions or medical cost, they're also worried about the cancellation cost.
Yeah, I think that's a very important point. What is the kind of cancellation benefits that you offer on your policies? Because that is now going to be a very, very important thing which people are going to look at. Trip cancellation, basically.
Correct. So trip cancellation, even in the pre-COVID times, you know, we covered a full cancellation cover, wherein there are two types of cancellation. There are two tiers, right? So one is a basic cancellation, which covers you in case of, you know, you get hospitalized or anybody in your family gets hospitalized. And our definition of family is a little more broader than most other products available, where we are covering, you know, not only your parents and spouse and children, but we also cover in-laws, because we had somebody, a very close friend, who came and said that, look, if my parents are covered, why not my wife's parent? That's her. She will only buy it if her parents are covered in the policy, right? So we had to include that in it. And like we always do, and we keep listening, we keep our eyes and ears on the ground. We listen to our partners, because they are our best teachers. And I think we have constantly kept evolving on the product. So from a trip cancellation point of view, we have medical covers in case if there's an unfortunate death, we cover. And we also had a cover that in case if there is any cancellation cost that you may have to incur because of any kind of an epidemic or a pandemic or a government restriction coming into play and you can't travel. So that's covered in our product. In our domestic plans, we also cover similar features, right? Where in today's time, so we are just in the process of introducing new COVID sort of created COVID kind of products, where you reach the airport and you're COVID positive, for example, and you're sent back. Then those kind of the flight is still flying, but you're not allowed to travel. So that will be covered on the product. So those are some new features that we have. But it's kind of a very comprehensive trip cancellation cover.
So, I mean, if there is an international travel and which includes a package and hotel bookings and tourist services, it would cover everything?
It covers everything.
Oh, that's great. And I think this, what you're talking about, domestic COVID, I think that's a fantastic innovation, because that is something which a lot of people are going to be looking for.
Yes.
Even if their trip has to be cancelled because of something like this. So I think that should really help in pushing domestic travel insurance.
Yes. I think some of the new words that we are using is staycations and leisure trips and all of that, right? So I think we are creating products to kind of support those trips where if you're on the road, most people are going to now drive and go wherever they're going for the domestic holidays. Like, that's what we see as a trend happening. Yes. So, we are covering things like on-site, roadside assistance, which means in case if your car breaks down, if you have an issue, you can still call us and we'll make sure that there is a towing van or there is some assistance provided to you. In case if there is your hotel where you are about to stay gets quarantined because of somebody's tested positive there, then we'll cover any cancellation costs or putting you to another hotel, etc. So all our products are now kind of making sure to I would say the post-COVID world travelers, right? And keeping that in mind, and especially the domestic side, I think there is a huge domestic travel which is about to happen in the next 12 months time.
So a lot of innovations with this COVID-19 coming up. But tell me, how did COVID-19 affect you as a company? Was there a huge effect? Was there a problem, or did the workload actually increase because of more claims?
So if you ask me, I know I am a big fan of this bear times, right? And I love them because we have seen similar times in the last 20 years. So whether it's you see the 2008-09 Lehman Brothers meltdown, if you see there was SARS, there was Ebola, a lot of things happened, right? Probably there was not too much of social media and news in those days, right? And having said that, I think definitely COVID is some bigger than most of the things that we've seen in the past. But yes, it's also highlighted more because of the social media. So we have seen times. You've been in business for so many years, much more than what I have. You have seen difficult times, right? You've seen times where people were not traveling for many times. Everybody discussed that now the business people will stop traveling. They will all do video calls and all of that. But I think it changed, right? It happens. It stays for 6 months. It's a hangover, right? And once the hangover is out, people want to start traveling. I think. No, you'll agree that you and I meeting personally in Bangalore is a different experience than what we're doing on the phone here, right? We don't enjoy this. We are humans, right? We don't enjoy doing this. So the question is, one, is travel going to come back? Certainly travel is going to come back, right? And I see it only as a pause, not as a full stop.
Great to hear all this from you. And any parting comments from your side before we come back to normalcy? What do you think we should all be doing?
So from a little bit of experience what I've had, I just feel we need to be optimistic. We need to be resilient in these times and make sure that we handhold each other and prepare ourselves for the best times to come ahead. I think travel has just begun in India. We've only seen the tip of the iceberg. In terms of the number of percentage that people travel vis-a-vis to what is in China and other countries, right? So there will be a travel boom. Contrary to what people say that people have lost jobs, etc., which I do agree. But also people have saved a lot of money in the last 3-4 months. We haven't gone out to restaurants. We haven't gone out and shop. We haven't done a lot of things. We haven't taken our summer holidays. So people, when the travel will start, I think it'll come back with a vengeance is what I feel. And we are always going to be supporting the travel agents, supporting the entire trade, and making sure that we both grow stronger and emerge as winners out of this.
Great, Dave. Thank you so much for those really optimistic words. And we hope to catch up with you once this COVID situation is over. But as of now, thank you so much for sparing your time. And for our viewers, we hope you enjoyed this show. And if you did, don't forget to click on like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, stay safe, stay healthy.